flames! Hello everyone, Kirk Yeehee here. Today we're playing WWE 2K18. This is a bonus video. We're going to be facing off against Enzo Amore in a one-on-one normal match. This is the Road to Glory mode, as you can see. This right here ends November 20th. I want to get out of the way as soon as I can because at this point I've only got 5 days. But after this, tomorrow, an event unlocks to face Baron Corbin. And then after that, an event unlocks to face, and what I'm assuming or hoping is a triple threat match, not a handicap, AJ Styles versus Brock Lesnar. All of this is working to get a piece of loot that you can only get in this mode. So, let's jump into this. Let's face off against Enzo Amore. I've already qualified for the match, so that's something. Yeah, as you can see, my look in here is a little different compared to what you see in the Universe mode. We'll see once the match starts up. Wish me luck, guys. We're going against Enzo Amore. As I said, this is the kickoff show, the Survivor Series. Oh, this is not a good start. This is a bad thing. In this mode, my stats, I am still only a 75 overall, so matches are a little difficult. Just a little difficult. As you can see, there's crap on in here, so I can see when the counters and stuff happen. That is exclusive to the online Road to Glory mode, though. They have it set like that by default, even though I do have my settings set up like it is in Universe mode. I cannot see anything. Even in the My Career mode, I cannot see anything. There's no HUD or any of that stuff. But I'm actually really glad they have that stuff on in the Road to Glory mode, because you'd never see them do anything otherwise. And as I've mentioned before, yeah, sit there and hold on your chin like an idiot. But as I've mentioned before, whoa, nope. Ah, damn. Things like this, or things are a little different here compared to the Universe mode. I have completely different move set because I have no choice in the matter. With the wrestling type I chose, I was limited to certain moves. I've tried my best to match up as close as I could to my other character, but even still, that's not very close. Let's get a taunt in here so we can get a buff going. Still no idea what these buffs do. I should really check through the online manual at some point to see. We'll taunt again just because we can. We'll go out here because I actually have... In my stats, I put my stats up a certain way, so I think it's 7% more damage out here. That doesn't help if I can't get any moves, though, does it? I have to assume that this is on Legendary out here, because it is in my Career mode, which, with these stats, can get really difficult at times. Especially, as you can see, I am out of counters. Because I am down a counter in this compared to any other mode. My counter is maxed out, and it gives me 4. So come on, Enzo, I don't want countered out. Shoot. He's working for the count out. I've got to get a reverse here.
Back now inside the ring.
Now I've got to be really careful because he has 2 freaking counters up on me. Which is, well, now he just has the 1 up on me, but I can't do anything. So I'm helpless to take an ass kicking right now. That is the downfall. And when I'm playing online, it's a little tricky because I have to try to anyone that has 5 counters, which I don't know what class you had to choose in order to get that. I know classes in wrestling seem so stupid, but whatever class it is, there's a certain class when you max it out when you get 5. So I wish I would have gotten that one so I could have had that as an advantage. But as things stand, just give me a second, guys. Okay, we got it. Okay, let's get our finisher in, and he reversed it. Oh no, I have to take another ass kicking because I have no reversals left. As I was trying to get out, when I play this online, I have to try to figure out a way to get people to do reversals before I do mine. I wouldn't have reversed that even if I could have, because it wouldn't have been worth it. Okay, let me punch him. Ah! Good, he reversed that, though. So here is an advantage to us if we could have reversed that.
Brewer looking a little low on energy here.
Yes, Brewer is a little low on energy here. Okay, he's looking me over.
He's just taking on so much
punch. Time this well.
3, 2, 1.
Nope.
But if he wants to pull away here,
nope.
He's going to have to mount.
I don't think that was his finisher, so I decided I better not. Okay. Huh. I don't think I reversed it this time. Oh, I did. I did. She's not over yet. Okay, this is rough. I hate if anyone hasn't heard. WWE 2K19, they've already said it's going to have paid microtransactions. If they're set up like these loot boxes are, it will effectively become a pay-to-win situation once again. And if and when that happens, I'll still buy the game, but that will completely end online. I refuse to play a mode where I have an unfair advantage. Either way, if I was, you know, oh, did you seriously counter me again? If I was to, you know, reverse, if I was to put $500 into loot boxes and always have it so I can have a super buff compared to, you know, people that has to pay, or the other way around, other people have to, or want to put $500 into boxes and force me to pay big, or, you know, have a huge disadvantage. It's a system that really pisses me off. And I hate that this is the way gaming's going. And I know I've made a video on microtransactions once already. The way EA's been just recently, as of what's today, the 15th, like the 13th and 14th. Ridiculous how greedy the companies are getting. And yes, I understand games or companies are in it to make money. Anyone's in a business to make money, but there's a line you shouldn't cross. When it comes to the point that you're blatantly trying to scam your own fan base, your player base, you're going too far. And that is essentially what they're doing with the way that they're setting up the microtransactions. The way that they're setting them up. But whatever. One, two, he's not going to give it to me that easy. He's not going to give it to me. Why do I have to fight three matches at Survivor Series? And I just realized that. Okay, we need him. We need to somehow get two finishers out of him, or two counters out of him, and I'm not sure how I'm going to do this. There's one of them. Ugh. Shoot, again! Oh! I gotta get out of there. I've gotta get that worked out of him. Let's just throw him back in there. Once again, I apologize for not having the face cam up and stuff, but with these matches, they typically happen if I play this game on my time before I go to bed, which right now it's 10:35. I'll be going to bed in about 40 minutes, 30 minutes, somewhere around there. We're going to get our finisher on you! All right, let's see if we can drag him over here and get the damn pin. He is hurt to a dark red. He can't get up after this. One, two, three. We've won our first qualifier, guys. Well, as I was saying, I apologize for the lack of face cam stuff, but where I'm playing this on my casual time, it's over on the TV and stuff. And yeah, that's long and short of it. At least you still get stuck toward your rank with these matches. So that was the prelims, the pre-show for the Survivor Series match. We'll see ya. Well, it'll depend on how fast I can get this video up. Depends on how small it is. I have to go. Yay! I had that already. So, this is interesting though. That right there is the TLC mask, more or less. I'm wondering if I'll get two more items for the Survivor Series pay-per-view. This is really interesting. Really interesting. But we'll find out another time, guys, because that's all there is for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you happen to enjoy it, leave it a thumbs up. I really appreciate that. If you want to, you can follow me on Twitter at KirkHeehee. Subscribe here on YouTube. Hit that little notification bell to be a part of the notification squad. You can also hit me up over on VidMe as well. I can put up videos over there under half an hour right now. So while not everything goes over there, the majority of the stuff can. And other than that, guys, I don't have too much left to say except for see you later, guys. Guys, my new YouTube and VidMe pals. I don't know. I broke there. Hi, I've been Kirk Heehee. But of course, I'm always Kirk Heehee. See you later once again, guys. And yes, I'm actually saluting and stuff with this.